He was a chief tax collector, a superintendent who others reported. And he was rich. Zacchaeus was trying to see who Jesus was, but he could not see because of the crowd, for he was short in stature. So he ran on ahead of the crowd and climbed up in a sycamore tree in order to see him, for he was about to pass through that way. When Jesus reached the place, he looked up and said to them, "Zacchaeus, hurry and come down, for today I must stay at your house." So Zacchaeus hurried and came down and welcomed Jesus with joy. When people saw it, they all began muttering in discontent, "He has gone to be the guest of a man who is a notorious sinner." Zacchaeus stopped and said to the Lord, "See, Lord, I am now giving half of my possessions to the poor. And if I had cheated anyone out of anything, I will give back four times as much." Jesus said to him, "Today salvation has come to this household, because he too is a spiritual son of Abraham. For the Son of Man has come to seek and to save that which was lost."
Thank you. Well, in honor of my mom and all moms who teach us, you gotta do your best. Just do your best. You'll be okay. That's all anybody asks. Do your best. And so, with that in mind, knowing that mom is always right, do your best, and you always do, because at whatever moment in time you're there with whatever energy and level of knowledge you have, of course you're going to do your best. Nobody says, I'm going to do my worst, I'm going to try a little. So the encouragement to be you, to do your best, has stayed with me and is something I remember my mom always saying. Just if Larry, if you do your best, that's all we're asking. So, taking as my best, my beautiful wife, Andrea, has told me I've only got one good sermon, and it's the Zacchaeus sermon. So today, the best for moms, and that is the sermon on Zacchaeus, which I preached here before a long, long time ago on a Boy Scout Sunday, I think the first one. But it's one of those stories that you can't ever hear enough of because it comes to us from the gospel. And it is not mine, it is Jesus'. This is Jesus' gospel, his word to us. And so, if you know anything about Zacchaeus, we heard the scripture read to us, and if you grew up around the church or in the church like I did, you went to Vacation Bible School, and you went to Sunday school, and you heard that little ditty that we all have in the back of our minds someplace, and that's that little song about Zacchaeus. It says Zacchaeus was a wee little man, and a wee little man was he. He climbed up in the sycamore tree for Jesus he wanted to see. And Jesus sees him and says, Zacchaeus, come down from there, for today I go homeward with you. So we got Zacchaeus. But I'm wondering, and I've titled the sermon other places, Up a Tree and Out on a Limb. Because that's where Zacchaeus goes. And I'm wondering, really, what would make a well-dressed, well-established businessman like Zacchaeus, who seemingly had it all together, who was a person of means and was a person who got respect because he was a tax collector for Rome, even though he was Hebrew by birth. But I always wonder, what would make such a person go up on a tree and out on a limb? I mean, you don't usually go downtown and see someone dressed in their finery sitting up on a branch. So what is it that truly made this Zacchaeus want to do that? He's seen lots of people before. He's seen prophets before. Why this particular one? Well, in order for us to really find out, we need to follow Zacchaeus around for a day or two. We just need to go with him on his travels and see what he's about and what he does and what's going on with him. So if you would, lend to me this morning your sanctified imagination, and I will lend to you the gospel story that we might have new eyes to see and ears to hear. So if you would, this morning, let me be that Zacchaeus. I'll be Zacchaeus of 2,000 years ago. I will take you around on a couple of days of work with me. So as any morning began, I got up in my house as Zacchaeus. I pulled out my day timer and I took a look to see what it was I would be doing this day. What did the appointments were going on? What is it that I needed to really be about doing? And so I look and, oh no. This is the day that I gotta go to the other side of town. This is the day that I gotta go on the other side of the tracks and try to collect from people that you just can't collect from. I hate going down there. I hate going to that side of town. It's dangerous, it's rough, it's nasty, and they never have anything but excuses. But Rome says I gotta collect, so I'm gonna collect. So off I go to that side of town, and as I'm going along, I I see there in the distance this house. It's disheveled. The roof has a hole in it. The grass, there's some tigers out there. The grass is growing up. It's just a mess. That's the address. So I come up and I knock on the door, and no one seems to be home. I knock on the door and I yell, "Hey, this is Rome, and Zacchaeus collecting taxes." Pretty soon I hear a little voice say, "Yeah, I know who you are." And right then a man stands. I think it was a man. It was hard to tell. His hair was everywhere, and he could tell that something was wrong. And I said, "I'm Zacchaeus." He says, "I know who you are." And I said, "Well, who are you?" And he said, "I'm the blind man that lives here." And I said, "Well, blind man, you got taxes." And he said, "Because I've been blind, I have no way of working. There is no society for the blind. There is no welfare from the state. There is nothing, and I have nothing. But if you give me just a little bit of time, if you give me just a little longer, I'll come up with the taxes, and I will pay you, Zacchaeus. I promise." Zacchaeus, not really wanting to stay around, thinking, you know, "What can I do to this guy? And the best we can do is come and confiscate your house and take your property away, and it will be done if you don't come up with the taxes. I will give you 30 days. There I was, stuck between mercy and money. "I'll give you 30 days, but in 30 days, you better have my money. Because if you don't, off to jail you will go, and we will take whatever this pathetic property will be sold for." He said, "Don't worry, Mr. Zacchaeus. In 30 days, I will have your money." Zacchaeus said, "Very good." And he punches it in, and he moves on to see where he's to go to next. I know this address. It's that old woman. She's usually at the doctor's. She's usually always at the doctor's, it seems. He knocks on the door, and a lady comes out. And she was all jaundiced looking and yellow, and she didn't look well at all. And I said, "I'm Zacchaeus. I'm here for the taxes." She said, "I know, I know. But for a long time, for 17 years, I've had an issue. It's a flow of blood that the doctors can't seem to stop. And I've been to every one of those doctors, and them quacks have taken all my money, and I don't have it for the taxes. But if you give me 30 more days, I'll come up with it somehow, some way, Mr. Zacchaeus. I'll come up with it." And I thought, "Man, yeah, you're just like that guy down the road there. You're not in very good health. I don't even know if you'll see another 30 days, but I'm not going to stick around here and argue with you. Okay, I'll give you 30 days. I told her, 30 days, you come up with the taxes, or Rome will be back and will confiscate your house as well." Zacchaeus marks it on his daytime, and he's thinking, "Well, I'm 0 for 2, not a very good day. And what's this? This is that spooky place by the gravesite." And he walks over, and there, in the corner of his eyes, he saw something move. He wasn't sure if it was beast or what it was. But he knocks on the door, and a lady answers the door. The door opens up, and the lady says, "Hello." And I said, "Yes, I'm Zacchaeus. I'm here for the Roman taxes." She said, "I know who you are." And I said, "Well, where's your husband?" My husband, he's not here. My husband's up there, running among the tombs. He's lost his mind. They say that he'll never be better. Everybody has tried to do something for him. They've tried to bind him, and they can't bind him. They've tried to hold him down, and they can't hold him down. He is supernaturally strong, and he's scaring us. I don't have any money." Zacchaeus said, "Well, I'll be back in 30 days. I'm not going to stick around here. That's pretty scary stuff. See what you can do. I'll be back." Whew! Get out of there. That's scary. One last one. Got to stop over here. Nain. This little village, Nain. As I was coming up to it, there on the door was a black wreath. And I know what black wreaths mean. It means someone has died. Oh, this is a terrible time for the tax man to come around, but Rome will be paid their due. So he knocks on the door, and the door opens, and the lady comes out. He says, I'm sorry for your loss, but I'm here for your taxes. She says, Mr. Zacchaeus, I had the tax money. And I was going to pay you today. I knew you were coming. And I was all set, but you see, like his daddy, my little boy has died. And I had to take that money, and I had to pay the funeral director so I could get him buried. Can I have a little more time? And like I got that money, I'll come up with some more money. Zacchaeus said, man, you people, I'll tell you, I come over here, no money, no taxes. I got to come back for theirs. You better see what you can do. I'll be back. So Zacchaeus, he walked on home thinking, it's not been a very good day. It's not been a very good day at all. Didn't collect a dime, not a nickel. Man can't make a living like this. Went to bed. A month passes. He's collected from other places, from other people. 30 days, he gets up one morning, he looks at his day timer. Oh, here we go again. Here we go again. On the other side of the tracks, to those other people that never paid, here we go. And off he went. And as he was going, he thought, I must have taken the wrong turn. That's the address, but the house looks completely different. The lawn is manicured. The timers are gone. The roof is fixed. There's a paint job. It doesn't look dilapidated at all. And who's that? Well, that's a different man standing in the doorway. That's not the same man that was here 30 days ago. The man here 30 days ago was blind, and that guy, he can see. And right then, the blind man who was blind, who was no longer blind, said, Mr. Zacchaeus, it's still me. It's still me. And he said, well, what in the world happened? He said, what in the world happened? Let me tell you what happened. I was blind and I heard this Jesus fellow was going to be in town. I heard the name Jesus from lots of people talk. And he said that he was the Son of God. And I thought, well, the Son of God ought to do something about these eyes, if anybody could. And I asked him, I said, if you would be willing, Jesus, you can make me see. And Jesus said, I am willing. And he spat on the dirt and he made some mud. He put it in my eyes and told me to go and wash. I did. And now I see. Mr. Zacchaeus, you got just a minute for me? You got just a minute? I want to tell you something. But things like this are best told in song. Listen up, Mr. Zacchaeus. Listen to this.
Tell me, I don't understand. She's said, Jesus. I heard that Jesus was going to be in town. I heard that Jesus was going to be close by. And so I went and I got into the crowd, and I didn't want to cause any problems or cause any trouble. I didn't want to, you know, make a big stir thing. So I reached through the crowd, and I thought if I could just touch the hem of his garment, if I could just reach out and there'd be healing in his wings, if I could reach out and his prayer shawl could be in my hand, and I did, and he did. And what the doctors couldn't do, Jesus could do. And when I was broken, he's made me whole. I was not well, I am well now. Mr. Zacchaeus, you got a minute, because I got to tell you something. And again, Mr. Zacchaeus, some things are best told in song. Listen up here. And since I haven't had to pay any money to all them people that are always willing to take it for nothing, since I didn't have to go to all them because now I am well, here's the money for the taxes, Mr. Zacchaeus. Be well yourself. I took that money and I thought, man, I'm lying. Man, I could see a woman who was dying. Now I mean, well, I just, Jesus. This Jesus is wandering around. I wonder, how would your father see him? What if I'll run into him? If I'll get to him? Because I got some, I'm not blind, but there's a lot I don't see. And I'm sort of well, but man, I don't feel nothing but broken. I wonder if there's something this Jesus can do for me. As he's walking along, he saw his tombstones. Oh, I'm back at that scary place. He was looking, he didn't see. He didn't see the guy running around. He went up and he knocked on the door. And the door opens. And standing there in the doorway is this tall, lean, mean, good-looking dude. And he said, yes, can I help you? I said, oh, I'm sorry. I was looking for the people that used to live here. That used to be here, that she said that she didn't have no money last time because her husband was up there running around. And he said, I am the husband. I said, what do you mean you're the husband? You were out of your mind. It said that no one could bind you, no one could keep you, nobody could take and keep you down in one place at one time. And his wife then steps out and she says, Mr. Zacchaeus, that was my mistake. You see, there was one who could. There was one who could. He showed up. He showed up, and the one who could was Jesus. And he said to Legion, be gone! And he was gone. And my husband was restored back to me in his right mind, full of health and spirit. Here's your money, Mr. Zacchaeus, for the taxes. Go in peace. Man, this has been so bad. I got 3 for 3 on money. That's a good thing. But a blind man, who ever heard of a blind man from birth being able to see? And a woman being made well, and demons fleeing from a man. Man, oh man, I don't know. This Jesus, though I don't have demons, I do got some stuff in me that I don't like. I got some things that I wonder if Jesus can do anything about my stuff. On to the last house. No. He looks, and the lady says, before you go, we want to tell you something in song. Because sometimes truths are best told in song. Listen to these words. Let us pray. God of all mystery, God of all goodness, God who is for us, not against us, God who loves and adores us and wants the very best for us, God who in the wisdom of your creation created human family, created the institutions of parent. For that, O Lord, this day we give you thanks and praise and honor and glory. For everyone here has a mother, whether that mother is well known or not, whether she is militant, alive, or has won her victory and is asleep in the Lord. We give you thanks and praise and honor and glory, Lord, for how you take care of us, your creation. You are for us a great God who is both like a father and a mother. You give us what we need and you continually seek after us. You make the blind see and the deaf hear. You cause the brokenhearted to be bound. You heal those who are ill. You feed us who are hungry and give drink without price to those who are thirsty. Come, Lord, now again, in a fuller measure into this world through our human hearts, that as we go home today, we take the promise that you come to our house this day and are with us forevermore. Make it so in the name of all names.